We'd like to welcome you all to worship today. We hope that you will continue watching our worship on YouTube or attending one of our in-person worships. On Thursday at 6:30 in the prayer garden, we will start a service 6:30 in the prayer garden this coming Thursday. Sundays at 8 o'clock in the prayer garden, and Sunday now, our Sunday parking lot service begins at 9:30 in the morning. We continue to email our prayer list, and if you haven't been receiving the emails, please make sure the church office has your updated email information. Wednesday nights in August, Wednesday night movie night, so there's gonna be a drive-in movie every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. in August in the parking lot here at church. We also want to remember the family of Gerald Kajawa as he died last week and his funeral was at Calvary. Finally, on Sunday, August 9th, there is going to be a children and youth service at 6:30 p.m. in the parking lot, so please join us. So today we begin our worship with confession and forgiveness, and I ask those who are here to stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open and all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit so that we may live and serve you in the newness of life through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. You may be seated.
Our opening hymn is As We Gather at Your Table.
As we gather at your table, as we listen to your word, help us know, O God, your presence. Let our hearts and minds be stirred. Nourish us with sacred story, till we claim it as our own. Teach us through this holy banquet how to make love's victory known. Turn our worship into witness in the sacrament of life. Send us forth to love and serve you, bringing peace where there is strife. Give us, Christ, your great compassion, to forgive as you forgave. May we still behold your image in the world you died to save. Gracious Spirit, help us summon other guests to share that feast, where triumphant love will welcome those who had been last and least. There no more will envy blind us, nor will pride our peace destroy. As we join with saints and angels to repeat the sounding joy.
Let us pray. Gracious God, your generosity waters the world with goodness, and you cover creation with abundance. Awaken in us a hunger for the food that satisfies both body and spirit. And with this food, fill all the starving world. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The first reading is from Isaiah, the 55th chapter. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk, without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. This ends the reading. The psalm is Psalm 145. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. Lord, you are good to all, and your compassion is over all your works. The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up those who are bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season. You open wide your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. You are righteous in all your ways and loving in all your works. You are near to all who call upon you, to all who call upon you faithfully. You fulfill the desire of those who fear you. You hear their cry and save them. You watch over all those who love you, but all the wicked you shall destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord. Let all flesh bless God's holy name forever and ever.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, now forever wilt be. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have need, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin, and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings are mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Our second reading comes from Romans, the 9th chapter. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 14. Now when Jesus heard about the beheading of John the Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw the great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not to go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all ate and were filled. And he took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Well, today we have a very, very popular text that I will want to talk about. But let's dig a little bit. Let's look at a background here. Here we see that John had been arrested. John the Baptist had been arrested and put in prison. He was put in prison because he spoke the truth that it was not right for King Herod to have his brother's wife. So he spoke the truth and he was behind by. So on his birthday, a party was going on. And a daughter danced so much that the mother of the girl said, "We want the head of John the Baptist." And because the king had made an announcement that whatever you want, I will give it to you, ask me, he wanted to keep his oath. The end result was that when he was so happy, and because he wanted to honor that, he ordered for John the Baptist's head, and they killed him. So Jesus heard about what had happened to his own cousin, his own John the Baptist. So he was in a grieving process after he heard about it. It's like any human being would do. He decided to take some time to grieve. But it is in this grieving process that he went to a deserted place. A place that was quiet. But even though he has gone to a deserted place, the crowd still follow him. When they find out where he went, the crowd follow him. Perhaps the crowd wanted to mourn with Christ. Perhaps because he did a lot of miracles, he healed. Maybe they followed him so that they could get healing too. On the other hand, because of what he had, the word of God or his preaching, they followed him. But scripture said there were about 5,000 men besides women and children. They followed him. When they saw Christ, they spent a whole day with Christ there until the evening. The disciple came to him, "Let us send these people away." Jesus said, "No. Give them what you have. Give them what you have." And all the texts will tell us that there was a little boy who have 5 loaves and 2 fish. Perhaps that boy, mother said, "You know why? Just carry this for the journey." It's almost like parents can say, before you leave your house, eat something. And while you're going out there, take something along with you. But our boy had 2 fish and 5 loaves. It was what that was in his hand that Christ decided to use. If we think about Calvary, we think about 3 times a week, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays, the food pantry open for people to come and get a food. Today I brought a bag of that, a As you can see, it's a bit heavy. And this is what Calvary give out weekly. And this is what you have been doing, your contribution have been doing, giving out food to the public, a physical food. But besides a physical food, we also receive spiritual food through the word, through the music that Ken used to play and sing. You've been hearing from our intern Claire. She's been sharing with you. And Katie is about to leave us. She also been ministering. And our other people have been sharing with you. But you have also, Pastor Jeff, been sharing here, been doing it. Other people have been doing it too. And I hope that you are also fed, glad that she will learn and have learned a lot, and she will be missed here. And we thank God for her service here. So we receive both physical and spiritual food from Calvary, and we're blessed for this ministry. But Christ, out of fear, he did not remain in a place. He did not stay. He did not say, because I am the Savior, I am the Son of God, so I'm going to fix it. No. But rather, he decided to leave because he knew that it was not yet time for him to die. So he had to go and mourn. He had to go and cry, perhaps. He had to go to a deserted place where he was. People of God, in a grievous time, something do happen. Jesus had compassion and love for the people. Because compassion and love can make someone to go beyond what they have no is not doing. A compassion in a way that they wanted to be identified with Christ. Compassion in a way that he felt for them. How could they go to the villages and buy food? But Christ was looking at something that they were not seeing. He was looking at God's provision for their lives. So when he told the boy, bring it to disciples, set the people up and told them to bring what he had. He took what was in their hand, blessed it, and gave it back to them. When the physical elements touches the supernatural, and God is able to bring that supernatural back to earthly, is able to satisfy whoever eats it. So even though it was not adequate in a physical sense, it was not enough, but God was able to bless it, and it became satisfactory to the people. There's a song that says, greater is much when God is in it. Greater is much when God is in it. It may seem to look like it's not enough, but God has a way of making it enough for his own people. God sometimes wants us to bring what we have so that he can bless in so many ways, so that it can be a blessing to others. Jesus bring up what has been blessed so that it can also multiply the rest of the people. But here's the point. It was not enough, but God was willing to multiply it. God was willing for them to have enough. As you think about this text, let's think about God's provision. And that provision comes in so many forms. Whether it's through daily work, it's through other providing, God is still able to do that for all of us. What's up with a little boy? He was willing to give up what he had for the use of the disciple or Christ. He was willing to give that. Then what about the disciples too? They were willing to be obedient to God. And because they obeyed, Christ said give it, and it did that. It became a blessing for all of them in that particular place and time. You know, God is bigger than ourselves. God is bigger than any situation we find ourselves. God is bigger than what we find ourselves in, because we believe and trust God, that God is able to do things that we ourselves cannot do. Because God's miracle, God's provision is greater than any other person can think about. When you think about what is done in this church or through this ministry, it's a lot. But God has been doing it for all of us and continue to do that. So as we go through this time, they wanted to be with Jesus, and Jesus wanted to be with them. He did not turn the crowd away. He gathered a crowd. When we come to Christ, He is not telling us go away. He rather welcomed all of us. And that's what He did. He was a God. Christ was full of compassion. And that compassion made provision for all. So as we reflect on this text, let's think about the multiple ways that God has been for all of us. No matter where we are in our life right now, He could take what we offer up to Him and all of our brokenness and pain, He's still able to take care of it. I know a pain cries that His cousin was gone, but as Haman, He still embraced that and did the work that God was calling him to do on the face of the earth. No matter the situation now, God remains with you, and God continues to be with all of us in this time of life. God's miracles, God's provision is great. God bless you. Amen.
Our hymn of the day is All Are Welcome.
Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where love is found in water, wine, and wheat. A banquet hall on holy ground where peace and justice meet. Here the love of God through Jesus is revealed in time and space. As we share in Christ the feast that frees us, all are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where hands will reach beyond the wood and stone, to heal and strengthen, serve and teach, and live the word they've known. Hear the outcast and the stranger, bear the image of God's face. Let us bring an end to fear and danger. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
Please join me in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Confident of your care and helped by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. You take resources that appear to be meager, bless them, and there is enough. May your church trust that what you bless and ask us to share with the world is abundantly sufficient. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your bountiful creation offers sustenance and life for all creation creatures. Protect this abundance for the well-being of all. Reverse the damage we have caused your creation. Replenish groundwater supplies, provide needed rains in places of drought, and protect forests from wildfires. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You offer yourself to all the nations and peoples of the earth, inviting everyone to abundant life. Bring the prophetic vision to fullness that all nations will run to you, and that nations who do not know you, you will find their joy in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. Hear the anguish of tender hearts who cry to you in suffering and satisfy their deepest needs. Bring wholeness and healing to those who suffer in body, heart, soul, and mind. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You offer freely the fullness of salvation. Give Calvary such a welcoming heart that our words and actions may extend your free and abundant hospitality to all whom we encounter. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You gather your saints as one, united in the body of Jesus. Bring us with all your saints to the heavenly banquet. We remember with love and thanksgiving the saints we have known. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In the certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, we offer these prayers to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of Jesus Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us pray for the offering. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things, through your goodness you have blessed us with the gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us in what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love, through the one who gave himself to us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, broke it, and gave it to disciples, and said, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." For as often as we eat this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Let us pray as Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the banquet. Behold the risen Christ. Please wait for us. We will partake together. Take and eat the body of Christ given for you. Take and drink the blood of Christ shed for you. Let us pray. O God, our life, our strength, our food, we give you thanks for sustaining us with the body and blood of your Son. By your Holy Spirit, you living us to be his body in the world, that more and more we give you praise and serve your earth and its many peoples, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate you from the love of Christ in Christ Jesus. The Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Praise and thanksgiving, God, would we offer for all things living you have made good. Harvest of sown fields, fruit of the orchard, hay from the mown fields, blossom and wood. Father providing food for your children, by wisdom's guiding, teach us to share one with another, so that rejoicing with us all others may know your care. Then will your blessing reach every people, freely confessing your gracious hand. Where you are reigning, no one will hunger. Your love sustaining showers the land.
Let us go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.